Well, a city council meeting is underway in Gulf Shores to talk about the future of the Hangout Music Festival.
Fox 10 News Baldwin County reporter Katie Weiss has been sitting in on that meeting and joins us live with an update on what's going on. Katie?
Hi, Bob. Well, this meeting is very important here for the city of Gulf Shores and for all of Pleasure Island because it has been found to generate some $30 million for the area. Now, I just heard in the meeting some results of same surveys that have been passed out this past week to local business owners and residents who live here in the area about what they think about the festival. And the results were a little surprising. Overall majority of survey responses were very positive, despite some of the negative feedback we've been hearing these past few months. However, there were some significant percentages of negative responses. Among local business owners, 57% said that there was a positive impact to their business, and 18% said that there was a negative impact on their business. As far as the citizens, a majority of citizens who responded said that they had not attended the festival. However, the majority of respondents did agree that a five-year extension for the Hangout Music Festival should be approved in 2 weeks. Now, 30% of those citizens, however, said that they do not agree that a five-year extension should be approved. Now, this meeting that is still underway here at Gulf Shores City Hall will help the Gulf Shores City Council to decide whether or not they want to give the Hangout Music Festival another five-year of business here on Pleasure Island. So I'm going to go back in and listen to what some of the public responses have to say. There are lots of people in there. It's a full house in the City Hall. So I'm sure that there are going to be a lot of people with a lot of opinions this afternoon. We'll have all of their responses tonight on Fox 10 News at 9 p.m., so be sure to stay tuned for that. Reporting live in Gulf Shores, I'm Katie Weiss for Fox 10 News.